So my first question in this part of the debate, and we're getting a lot of you who are responding, we'll be starting to take some calls in some time. My question is to Mr. Jitendra Awad, National General Secretary and leader of the NCP, joining us from Mumbai. Mr. Awad, what if people say, let's do get the demolitions going, but let's start, charity begins at home. Let's first start by making the politicians accountable. Let's ask Ajit Pawar, Gopinath Munde, Manik Rao Thakre, Patang Rao Kadam, and the rest. What action was taken on their homes in which illegalities were found? Should we start there instead of starting with these people?
Yes, sir. Surely you should start with everybody who has broken the law. There should be no discrimination.
Why then is there discrimination?
Clear with you. 1 minute, Mr. Arnab Goswami. Please allow others to speak.
Why is there discrimination?
You were the same person. We were the same person. Mr. Arnab Goswami, when I took up the issue in Mumbra, when I stopped people from breaking homes, getting evicted, you were the same news anchor who screamed and shouted that how can politicians go and stop demolition? This is an event just 6 months back. I think you should be clear on discrimination. Just because those people who were staying in their home belong to a poor locality, Times Now had a big issue on this. I'm very happy today that you are taking a positive stand on Campacola.
First of all, Mr. Jitendra Awad.
Mr. Arnab Goswami,
Mr. Jitendra Awad. You know
this
what? You know what,
Mr.
Awad? The problem with you. Can I tell you the problem with you? The problem with you is that you do not pay attention to detail. At that very point of time, we had questioned what was going on the ground in Mumbra, and the question which we raised, which you want to avoid today because it is not convenient to you, is why the municipal authorities. 1 minute, Mr. You can't, you see, Mr. Awad, you can't say something wrong and get away with it. You understand this? This is not your political rally.
I never do that. When I call a spade, I call a spade.
Yeah, you see.
I am not scared of answering anybody in this world. I am only answerable to
Mr.
my Lord and
I have said this to you, that this aggression, this finger pointing which you do, it's water off a duck's back.
Don't worry, Rahul
Narvekar tried it with me. I said it's not going to work. I am saying today, Mr. Jitendra Awad, just you please answer the simple question. Mr. Awad, one minute. You see, apply the law.
I should remind
apply,
what you have said.
Apply the law. You cannot remind people of wrong things which people have not said. You must understand,
Mr. Awad,
at that point of time.
Of
Mr. Awad, 1 minute. Mr. Awad, now you know you will have to listen. You will have to listen. You know, you may be a politician, does not give you the right to uninterrupted
speech.
Yes, Arnab
Goswami, you also make a habit to listen.
You must not, you must understand, Mr. Awad.
If you tell me the name of your
deputy chief minister is Ajit Pawar, what action do you want against his house? And why has no action been taken
then
in his house and action taken against these people's houses?
If there is any illegality done, Mr. Arnab Goswami,
I know my name, don't repeat it so many
by
times.
Anybody, may it be a media baron, may it be a media house, or may it be anybody who has done illegality should face.
That is precisely the question. Mr. Mehta from Campacola is asking you a question. Jitendra Awad, have the humility to listen. Listen and have the humility to listen. You are getting a question here, and people will ask you if politicians' houses go unchecked. No, one second. Milind Deora also wants to come in. 1 second, Mr. Jitendra Awad. Calm down. Mr. Mehta has asked you a question. Milind, I'm coming to you after
Mr.
that.
Mr. Awad, this is easier said than done. Shubhda is exactly less than a kilometer away from our place. It is standing tall with all allegations. Not a finger is being pointed after that. And our buildings are being brought down with brutality and in extreme urgency. We fail to understand why this urgency to bring our buildings down. And it's easy to say that all politicians are nobody, everybody is equal before law, but it's not happening in the city. Or in the country for that matter.
And you know why? Because the middle class taxpaying citizen is not seen to be a vote bank.
No, that's a mistake.
And that's principally
that's
the issue out here. Milind wanted to come back. Shaina and see, welcome to the debate. Abha, welcome. Coming to you in a minute. Milind.
My limited point is because I think with due respect, we are digressing a bit on this topic. The issue with regards to how builders across the country often construct illegal buildings dupe home buyers is something which has been prevalent in our society, sadly, for many, many decades. With regards to Campa Cola, your first question, Arnab, which is a very pointed and important question, which is, you ask the residents also, what if someone says your building is illegal? And I believe Nandini Mehta said it rightly to you, that in the 80s, the country was a very different country. There was no RTI. The home buyer wasn't as aware as they are today. The builders also, to some extent, perhaps in some ways have gotten better over time. But I think what is important is, rather than looking at things in hindsight and saying, okay, this is something which is illegal and now we need to regularize it and we need to go to the court and we need to seek legal options, the long-term permanent solution for this problem across India, I firmly believe, and I hope other panelists will agree on it as well, is to really have a strong regulator in our country.
No, that's,
and that's something that the,
that's exactly, no, but right now we are trying to save people's lives. I take your point.
That if there is a builder who's promised something,
long term is okay.
Deliver, see, that builder is punished. Does not punish the official.
I have a question.
And more importantly, that the home buyer stays protected.
That's all right. You see, no. One sec. Tonight, you know, Mr. Deora, you know the problem is.
Mr. Deora, you know the problem is
people are losing their home. I want to ask Jitendra Awad one question. Mr. Awad, do you have any connection with the Adarsh building in any way? You know anyone who has a house there?
Yes, I have a house in Adarsh.
So, how come your house doesn't get demolished? So your house doesn't get demolished?
Ask the court. The matter is subjudiced. The matter is in the court. You better be a party to it, go into the Supreme Court, High Court, get it demolished.
Why are you getting so angry? I'm asking you a question. Why are you losing your shirt? I'm asking you a question. You're getting a counter question, Rahul Narvekar, but before that,
Jitendra Awad never loses a school.
No, you're not. My question goes answered. Adarsh is not demolished. Jitendra Awad's flat stays. Mayawati gets to build her super bungalow. Ministers and chief ministers don't lose their houses. This honest middle class citizens sitting next to me, who have been paying property taxes for a quarter of a century, will lose their homes because you want to make an example of them. Because 50%, I say to you tonight on your face, 50% of the houses in Mumbai are illegal. And believe me, Mr. Jitendra, if you think anyone in the country thinks the politicians have no hand in it, you'd be fooling yourself. Shaina NC.
You know, yesterday when we met the chief minister,
beating politicians is not going to solve your problem.
Who's beating? I'm asking you questions. The root cause is that you've not been asked these questions till now. You need to be asked these questions. Please understand, as someone who has a house in an illegal building, you should understand the circumstances in which these things happen and why politicians get away. Sorry to make it personal. But I had to ask that question. Shaina NC, please. Shaina NC.
When we met the chief minister,
it's all right, Mr. Jitendra Awad. You know that you may not have a soft corner for me because I asked the question on others, but I think it exposed you there.
Just because you are an anchor.
It's all right. Shaina NC, please.
When we met with the chief minister yesterday, we just requested him that you have the discretionary power. Why, under an extraordinary situation, are you not using it to help the so-called middle class? Now, if we make amendments for slum dwellers, whether it's 95, 2000, 2005, is this not an exception to the rule? The point here is 25 years ago, three fraudulent builders constructed this building. They did something wrong vis-a-vis with the BMC as a conduit. The point is, now if they're willing to pay the penalty, give up some part of their land, and if legal opinion from the Attorney General and the Advocate General are being sought on behalf of all political parties, I don't think that we have to view everything as right versus wrong.
Why?
There is compassion, there is a feeling of sensitivity.
What action has been taken against Gopinath Munde's house?
750
What action has been taken against Gopinath Munde's house?
My point is, if you have 6,000 buildings in this city that do not have an occupation certificate,
China,
is everyone China, going to be no parity you, you, of you law then parity of law for all 56,000 you can't
China
single out
that
one
we are a middle, we are that's middle exactly class. What we I'm
saying
vote bank.
That's exactly
so
what
why
I'm
should
saying
they care about us?
There is no vote bank politics here. This is 750
who's going to believe you when they you
this
say there's
exactly,
no
but this is what we appeal to
1 minute now one
my question to all the representatives of the political parties here is that today forget for a second Camp Akola today there are so many environmental issues where people are not people lawfully cannot make buildings on mangroves on CRZ1 in different areas. Even now we are fighting this that they should not build buildings on the places where they're not supposed to. We are not getting any support Arnab from any political party in this city. They are all hand in gloves with the builders. We are fighting day in and day out in Lokhandwala, Oshwara, Bandra. I can show you more than 100 buildings which are illegal in suburbs. And I don't want to make it local, but the point is all these politicians, all these political parties, if they are really concerned about this common man why are they not taking
please remember one thing. You have been, have you played any role in the municipal council over the last many years? If you have been, then the fact of the matter is you allow the illegalities. And now you
absolutely
want to make an example of it. You but allow the illegality and you switch over. You must realize where you stand. The middle class Indian suffers because of your dual standards and your hypocrisy, Shaina. That's the fact of life. I want to go across to Ramji Chandran today, who's editor-in-chief of Explosity. Well, I'll come back to you. You can give me a quick report if you want to. If you think it's unfair, it's fine. I think that's the bitter reality you need to come to terms with.
Arnab, do you want me to continue?
Ramji Chandran is, yes, I certainly would like you to, but Ramji Chandran joining from Bengaluru has been waiting for a long time. Thank you for your patience, Ramji Chandran. As someone who deals with these urban issues, do you think what's happening in Mumbai is simply accidental? Do you think the politicians have no role in it?
Well, I personally believe the politicians have a role in it. But I have something first to say about what's happening with the Camp Akola residents in Bombay. To begin with, I don't think that caveat emptor, let the buyer beware, should be applicable to middle class people. They don't have the means to be able to check everything that they can check about the legality of an apartment block. You know, it's a lifetime purchase. It's not a toaster. They can't just be expected to do it. So I believe that whoever the authorities are, whether it's the judiciary or the executive, should first protect the middle class people, the apartment owners. And instead of establishing that there's a unstated collusion between them and the builders, so that's one thing I don't buy. The second part of it is, I'm cynical enough to believe that this is not going to change. I think that out of, you know, the oldest economic adage is out of land comes wealth. So everyone is going to control wealth. Of course, every politician is involved, every builder is involved. Who can even construct a simple business in India without getting his way around the bureaucrats? Now, there's only one thing that I'd like to say, Arnab, is that I've been hearing everything about politicians. I would like you to inject into this discussion the culpability of the bureaucrats, without whom the politicians can't do anything.
So I totally agree.
Yes, I think that there's a nexus, and I believe that nexus will stay forever.
I totally agree with you, Ramji. Thanks very much for that. See, that opens it up. The system has crushed these individuals. Abha, let's come to you. You know, are there dual standards for politicians and the Aam Aadmi? And has this got to do with the politicians' basic lack of interest towards the taxpaying middle-class Indian in this case?
See, of course, if you
how
see
many, how many, for example, how many slum clusters get regularized and regularized at speed by flouting all kinds of norms simply because politicians believe that they are, you know, they'd be a ready vote bank whenever they are required.
See, that of course is true that slums are a vote bank, and that is why there have been regularization of the slums. But in this case, there's one very pertinent point is